Hello everybody and welcome again to a new session in the lecture series of linear algebra. So, in this session we are going to focus on using the Gaussian elimination to solve a system of equations with three variables. So, let's start with this problem. Let's say we have this set of equations u plus v minus w is equals negative 2, 2u minus v plus w equals 5, negative u plus 2v plus 2w equals 1. So, how we can use matrices to solve this system of equations, right? The first thing, we need to convert it into an augmented matrix. Remember, in our last session we have discussed this, how to convert a system of equations into an augmented matrix. We have talked about that. If you haven't gone through that, please do this, so that you can understand this session much better. Okay, so let's write the coefficients in this matrix form. We have 1u plus 1v minus 1w. And let's use a vertical bar to separate the left-hand side from the right-hand side of the equation. So I am going to put negative 2 on this side. Now, for the second equation, the coefficients are 2, negative 1, and 1. And for the last equation, it's negative 1, 2, 2. Yeah. Now, what I am going to do is convert this matrix into rho echelon form. Okay. And what is that? Well, I want these three numbers to be 1, the diagonals to be 1, and I want these numbers, that is beneath the diagonal, to be 0. This is the definition of rho echelon form. Okay, so let's make those three numbers in green 0 first. So what I am going to do is, I am going to add rho 1 and rho 3 together, and I am going to apply that change to row 3, that is the third row. So first, let's rewrite the matrix. The first row is not going to change. All of the changes will be applied to row 3, yes? So I can rewrite row 1 and row 2 is also not going to change. Now, row 1 plus row 3. So, for column 1, it's going to be 1 plus negative 1, and that's going to be 0, as what we want. And then for second column, it's 1 plus 2, which is 3. And then it's a negative 1 plus 2, which is 1. Okay, and that's going to be negative 2 plus 1, which is negative 1, the fourth column. Now, the next thing I want to do is convert this 2 into a 0. So, I am going to apply the changes to row 2. To the second row, okay. And for that, I am going to multiply the first row by negative 2, because this will become negative 2, and then I will add that to row 2. So I am going to write it out step by step for this one. So here's the operation that I am applying here, which is known as the matrix row operation. So, for column 1, And in row 1, we have an entry 1. So R1 is going to be 1. And for row 2, column 1, the entry is 2. So negative 2 plus 2 is 0. This is going to be 0. Now, for column 2, we are going to use these two numbers. So in column 2, R1 is 1 and R2 is negative 1. So this is going to give us negative 3. And for column 3, R1 is negative 1. And R2 is 1. So negative 2 times negative 1 is 2. And then add 1 to that. That will give you 3. For the fourth one, fourth column, R1 is negative 2 and R2 is 5. So negative 2 times negative 2 is 4 plus 5, that's 9. And everything else will remain the same, okay? So let's rewrite the other numbers and then let's just get rid out of this. Okay, so what do you think is the next thing that we should do at this point? Well, we need this number to be a 0, yeah? So all we got to do is add rows 2 and 3 and we need to apply the changes in row 3. So it is going to be R2 plus R3. So row 1 and row 2 stay same. If we add R2 plus R3 from column 1, that's 0 plus 0, that's equal to 0. For column 2, R2 plus R3 is going to be negative 3 plus 3, which is again 0 as what we want. And for column 3, it's 3 plus 1 is 4. And finally, for the fourth column, 9 plus negative 1 is 8. Now, if I wanted to, look, I can convert this back to a system of linear equations, okay? And by using back substitutions, we can easily get u, v, and w in this form. But what I want to do is, I want to convert it into a row echelon form, okay? So I want to convert these three numbers into 1. Okay. Now, I don't need to change this since this is already 1. But these two, they need to be converted into 1. Okay. So therefore, simultaneously for row 2, I am going to multiply by negative 1/3 row 2. And for row 3, I am going to multiply it by 1/4. So row 1 will not change, so let's rewrite that. And row 2, we are going to multiply everything by negative 1/3, that is dividing everything by negative 3. So negative 3 divided by negative 3, that's positive 1. 3 times negative 1/3 is negative 1. 9 times negative 1/3 is negative 3. Now the third row, 4 times 1/4 is 1, 8 times 1/4 is 2. Now what we need to do is convert this back into a system of linear equations. So column 1 is the coefficients for u, this second column for v, and the third column is for w. So the first equation is u plus 1v minus 1w is equals minus 2. The second one is 1v minus 1w equals negative 3. And the last one is 1w is equals 2. So in this form, we automatically get the solution, isn't it? So now that we have W, let's plug it into the second equation to get V. So V minus W, or V minus 2 equals negative 3. Now let's add 2 to both sides to get rid out of this negative 2. So negative 3 plus 2 is negative 1. Therefore, V is equal to negative 1. Now let's take V and W and plug it into the first equation to solve for U. So we are going to have U plus V, where V is negative 1, minus W, and W is 2, and that's equal to negative 2. So negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3. And if we add 3 to both sides, negative 2 plus 3 is 1. So U equals 1. Okay, we have the final answer. So in the form of U, V, W, it's going to be 1, negative 1, and 2. So see, this is the solution, and keep this thing in mind that this form is row Echelon form, okay, where you have a diagonal of 1s and zeros beneath it. Yeah? And one thing, it really doesn't matter what's here, okay? So keep that in this mind that this is the row Echelon form.